Ati kout pa oui, manje san, ye pis avoka. Moucha sap se kwe yola, nou ka sel kwe konsa. Ati te kako, ki bien show, e pi te kako. Ati bot e pi solo, chapo la poko.
Welcome back to another episode of Manje La Kai. We are in a beautiful home and I am Mona Lisa alongside the lovely Allison Monrose, alongside the lovely Perpetua, alongside some beautiful guests. And we have some beautiful stuff ready to be made for you today. How are you doing, Ali?
I'm doing amazing. And how are the guests doing?
Very good. Thank you. Good.
And let's not forget our chef. How are you doing?
I am good. Ready to rumble, as they say.
Oh, yes. Right. Why are you making fun
today? Today we'll be making a local bouillon. With home salted pigtail, home cured pigtails, with dumplings, spinach, and some dashin. Yes.
We can't wait.
And I have one more surprise. We are making avocado with furring balls, and that would be served on a bed of saltfish, our local saltfish. So we are making two dishes today. So we have guests who we have to introduce to our local home cooked meals.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So we need to give them a double dose of it.
Definitely. Are you excited to try our meal?
Yes. Can't wait.
Can't wait as well. So without further ado, let's get started. What is the first step in this bouillon?
Well, with the bouillon, we make, we have split peas. I use split peas today because it's a very light soup. Okay. And with the split peas, you have actually a lot more control. For me, we have a lot more control. So we would take our split peas and wash it out. Okay, so we go to the sink, wash it out, let it soak for a bit, an hour or two. Sometimes we do it overnight, depending on how early we want to cook. So, right, we'll soak it in, and our meat that has been salted. So what we do, we buy it fresh. And we just sprinkle it with salt. We cut it up and sprinkle it with salt. Okay. It can be done a day in advance. It could be done weeks in advance, depending on how cured you want your meat done. Mm-hmm. All right. Yes. And we have our dashin, which we're going to peel and dice.
Okay.
And put it in the pot. We have our spinach, right,
okay,
which will be added to the pot as well.
Nice.
And we have dumplings. We have to make our dumplings, which is basically a starch. It's flour. Kneaded with salted water, made into a stiff dough, and we add it to our pot. So this is one meal. For our furring and avocado, it's we have the cassava, which it's a root vegetable, so it's been grated, dried, so most of the starch has been removed. And we use a large iron pot to cook it down. So we're gonna use this with ripe avocado. This is gonna be mixed together. And your salt fish, traditionally it's roasted, and then we wash it out, and then we do it, you know, with garlic, onions, peppers, whatever it is we do. So this is what the appetizer is gonna do. So you're gonna make the furring balls, roll it into balls, make a nice saltfish mix, and that would be laid on top. So we would cover a good bit of the easy everyday food that was used. All right.
We all like that furring balls. You know, you remember last time? Yeah. Let me tell you, we are very much a fan of furring balls here, so
okay,
we are excited on that.
Okay.
So, all right. What do we start with?
So, as anything else, we will start with our peas that has to go into the pot first.
All right.
So we're gonna wash.
Okay. And we're here to help her. We always like to
yes.
wash any chopping, cutting, soaking. Yes.
Well, what brought you to St. Lucia? Did you know about us before, or was it like you got a suggestion maybe?
Yes, we're here on our honeymoon.
Okay.
And we wanted to pick the most romantic place we could think of, and that was St. Lucia.
That is definitely St. Lucia, number one honeymoon spot in the whole Caribbean.
Yes.
Yes, it is. Nice. How are you enjoying St. Lucia?
It's beautiful. We absolutely love it.
Yes. At least, you know, we have something that we could have given you. And now that you get to experience a little bit more about St. Lucia, the local food. Because you came in such a great month.
Mm-hmm, the best month ever. In Creole, you're going to get all the delicacies.
Exactly. That's why we have our little Gine Creole colors and patterns. And we cannot wait to see what you think of the food. Because we know it will be good, but we hope you find
the flavor.
We can't wait to try it.
Let me tell you, I know, right? What's happening?
No, the pot is on. Mm-hmm. The peas is on.
Nice.
So that would have to boil for a while.
Okay.
So in the meantime, we're gonna work with our onions. We're gonna cut our onions. Yeah. So since it's a soup, it's gonna be a rough chop, right? Just a very rough.
Do you know how to avoid getting your eyes watery and tearing?
No.
I see you going all in. Ali can tell you a little about that.
I recall I had this friend, God rest her soul, when we worked in the kitchen together and she had onions to do, right?
Mm-hmm.
She wore diving goggles because she figured the diving goggles would fit really tight on her eyes, mm-hmm. so that nothing could go in, but that didn't work. So I do not know the secret for it.
Well, there's a few ways, and in our journey, throughout Kaimaji journey, we found out there's a few different ways. Because the onions, what happens, the reason you cry is the liquid of the onion is trying to find the nearest water source.
Mm.
So the nearest water source is our tearducts, mm-hmm. so it makes us cry. But to avoid the crying, you could either cut the onions in a sink with some running water, or you can cut it on next to a damp paper towel, or if you just leave the butt on the onion, it doesn't do anything to you.
News to me. Thank you for letting me know.
Yes, I don't have to do it.
Because in all of my years of chefing, I have not been able to find a resolution or a solution for the crying.
Yeah. I also heard you can chew gum and it will prevent that.
Oh.
I tried it once, it worked.
It did?
Yes. Mm. I don't know the science, but I can figure it out if you give me about 5 minutes.
Okay. So we're taking from our bounty here, right?
Yes.
So we have the garlic, we have the seasoning pepper. No pun intended. It's just good. It's bounty. It's our national drink. So
right. You have tried bounty, right?
Yes.
Okay, if you all didn't, I'll say, huh? Yeah.
Okay, so with, we have our rough chop onions. We do the same with the garlic. Since we're not mincing, it's just another rough chop, so I'm going to do this. And just pull it through here.
I like the way she just flattened the knife on that garlic.
Yeah, yes. It gets all the aroma out.
Yes, it does. It does. It does. It does. Yes,
yay.
It brings it out.
Very nice.
Again, we're gonna do our garlic. The garlic is gonna be rough chop. Don't worry about the size because it will all dissolve in the soup, right?
Yeah.
And our infamous seasoning pepper.
Infamous.
Yes, it adds a particular, just a different taste. It is not as pungent as our hot peppers,
mm-hmm.
and it's not as mild as our sweet peppers.
Yes.
There's just this balance. It's just a different flavor. Mm-hmm. It just adds a different dimension to what we're doing.
Well, as you know, I love sweet peppers because I don't really do well with spice. But you know, I'm eager to try anything. I would love to raise my spice tolerance.
Yeah.
You know, they made fun of me in the past, Majela guys, you know, because we experienced a nice avocado sauce that was a little too
pungent, too spicy
for you. For me, but everyone else enjoyed it, and I enjoyed it. It was just
too hot.
You know, too hot. For someone that does no hot meat, zero, none. Sorry, guys. I'm a disappointment,
yeah.
I know.
And for somebody who has Indian roots.
You're not a disappointment. You're just coming up slowly.
You know, I'm trying
that's
to raise the heat tolerance, so we're trying.
You're going
to
get there.
You're going to get there.
Okay, for our meat, we have the salted pork that has been rinsed out and soaked, right? So we're going to take that. and put it into the pot. I'm gonna put it into the pot where the peas and so is thing in there. Alright.
So how long? Tell me about your story. How did y'all meet?
At work.
We work together.
We met my second day, and we really hit it off right away. And it wasn't long before we started dating, and we were engaged a year, and we just got married this past Saturday.
So we haven't even been married a week yet.
Oh, it's not a week yet. Yeah. So how are you enjoying it so far?
It's great.
Loving it. We love it.
Is this your first time in San Jose?
Yes.
Oh, okay. So new marriage, new location.
We will let that simmer. Let you cook that. So it would probably take about half an hour to an hour for the peas to get, you know, soft and the meat to get soft. So we just let that simmer.
Is there anything in particular you're planning on doing in San Jose?
Just relaxing, enjoying.
The
pitons. I think you want to see the pitons.
Yes. Have you all tried the pito bear?
Yes.
We have. That we have.
Okay. How like that?
Delicious.
Of course it is.
It's one of the top bears on island, actually. Yeah. I think it's a staple in every Lucian household.
It is, though. I have some in my house right now.
Okay, so... we're gonna just gonna prep the rest of the stuff for our bouillon, because the meat, the peas, and the rough chopped onions, peppers, and garlic will probably take about half an hour, 45 minutes to 1 hour.
Okay.
You have to let it simmer and let the flavors combine, let the peas soften and the meat cook and so. So we're just gonna do all our prep for it. Okay. So the spinach.
Spinach makes you strong like Popeye.
Yes. So. The leaves have been washed and dried, so again, everything is going to be a rough chop because it's just going into soup.
Definitely. Right?
So we're not looking for any special cuts or anything like that.
I remember that hand technique. I tried it at home.
It works?
My lettuce. Yes.
Okay, good.
It came out so good. I'm so tired of Mona Lisa.
Yes.
So this is one of the ones that Mona Lisa fails to chop. Cut, slice, so we're trying to help her become better in the kitchen.
Definitely.
Nice. Okay, so this is our dashing. This is our ground provision that we will be adding to the soup as well. So we're just going to peel, cut, and put on the side. Now with the dashing, I've heard it all my life. I have never not done it. Because there is this thin line between the skin, there's like almost like a membrane here. There is this line, and for all my life I've been hearing that if you do not cut it off, it will scratch, it will itch your throat, right?
Okay.
So I do not know if it's true or not because I've never done it without removing it. Okay.
And we're not here to experiment.
No, we're not experimenting with that.
We need to.
Yes.
Never.
Yes. Okay, so then you need to make sure, so if the camera gets it, there is this little line right here between the skin. All of my life I've heard that it needs to be removed. If not, you're going to have an itchy throat. So this is our dashing, so you're going to cut it into bite-sized pieces.
Oh, wow. Okay.
All right, and just
put it in that bowl.
Put it in water.
Yeah. Why are we putting it in water?
Just to keep it, sometimes it changes, it gets kind of dark, but it's also a starch, it's very starchy, so it dries up quickly, right? So
we don't want it to, you know, be too dry in our mouth, give it more juice. We don't want
We do not want that at all. And gorget for our guests,
yes,
you do not know.
Oh yeah.
It's like a hiccup. If you eat something really dry, you know, you have that hiccup and you want to have to run get water, this is what we call gorget here.
Okay.
So,
yeah, it's almost like a garden reflex.
Yes.
So if anything that is too dry,
yes,
we kind of call it, it gives you that gagging, oh, I need some water. Okay, so we're gonna set that aside. Yes.
That's correct. You know any other Creole words?
I don't think so. No.
Oh boy, so you have to put that in your bank.
I might know one. Hold on.
Which one?
Sapase?
Sapase. Sac passé.
Sac passé.
Yeah.
Ah, sac passé. Sac passé. Drink your drink. Sac passé. Yeah.
But it's me.
So, Pet, I'm coming to you because I'm not even sure.
I think a lot of people do that actually. Say the words that they don't know the actual meaning behind it. It's really fun, actually. Because by the time you're trying to find out, what does this mean? Everybody's like, I don't know. But they know it in that context.
Right.
So we're good at speaking it or communicating, using it, but we're not good at explaining to others.
Yeah, we just. And that would be the younger generation.
Yes. Of course, the older ones have it down pat.
They have it down pat.
But the language is getting a little lost, so we're trying to really bring it back. Especially this year after COVID and everything, we're trying to bring it back in Mazi Lakai and in all our other Creole activities for the month.
Yes, definitely.
Important.
You say sac passé. Sac passé is more, if when we say sac passé here, we ask you what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
But hold on, in the Haitian dialect, when they say sac passé, it's what's happening. But here, if we ask you what's going on, we say sac a fête.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right? So there is a slight, you know, deviation. It means almost the same, but for Saint Lucia we say sac a fête.
Okay.
The Haitians say sac passé.
Okay.
For our dumplings, we just some flour in here. Mm-hmm. Alright.
I've always admired the simplicity of making a dumpling.
Yeah.
I think this simplicity goes with Creole food altogether.
Yes.
Yeah. I think sometimes when we do too much with it, we kind of get lost and we lose the flavor.
Yes.
So the simple is just water, some salt. Okay.
Have you ever tried to make dumplings?
I think I've made dumplings before, yeah, definitely.
Was it successful?
It was successful, like I said, the simplicity of making the dumplings.
Okay, so for the dumplings, it's just a little bit of water in here, and yes, we use... Now, we have different kinds of dumplings, and the size and texture, mm-hmm, the density of it determines the kind of dumpling it is.
Yeah.
Okay.
If you have in a kudme, which is a self-help, community self-help thing, we normally make these huge dumplings that's heavy like stone. And everybody probably gets one or two, depending on how much you could eat, and then you could cut it up.
Yes,
the duff, right. So we just need it. The least amount of water, as you know, they would depend on the texture of it. So we just go.
So, Pat, do you have a favorite local dish?
Yes, it's too many to choose from, but I like the simple things. I just like, before I go into a restaurant to eat, mm-hmm, I'll probably just go drive down south and eat by the roadside. And for me, the more authentic thing is at the roadside.
Yeah.
Yes, some people may be concerned with food poisoning. I'm never, because we cremate everything 3 times when we cook it on the roadside. So, you know, we good.
Wow.
Yeah, everything is always overcooked. So the chance of food poisoning, it can happen, but it is not something that is very common. All right. I just like authentic stuff. So anything authentic, a fish broth, maybe some octopus or so just thrown on the grill with a local herb sauce is fine with me. Or just boil in salt water and just eaten, that's fine with me. When too much is done to the food, it kind of compromises the real flavor and stuff. So
yep.
I just like just the real stuff.
Yeah.
That's me. So as for a favorite one, not really, just anything that is tasty and not overpowered by anything. Yeah?
Yeah. Yes.
What did you learn to cook? Was that always your passion?
No.
Talk to me.
It wasn't always.
What was that?
You know, as a young girl, we all want to dress in the short skirt, the jackets, and the high heels, right? Mm-hmm. Yes. I tried it, but I realized it wasn't for me.
So what exactly was the passion?
No, you just want to dress up in the high heels, work in an office, you know, have your jacket on, your short skirt and whatever it is, you know, like the girls in the magazine. Mm-hmm. But then you realize really and truly it's not for me. I am not one to sit at a desk.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. I'm more of a creative. I like exploring. I like meeting people. I like talking, you know, so these things came and I just found, so I just... My uncle was a chef. My grandmother was a bad home cook. When I say bad, I mean in the Michael Jackson, it's bad, it's bad, right?
Bad,
yeah. Yes. So it was kind of a natural thing for me to gravitate towards that. And I have not regretted it one bit, all right? So for our dumplings, so our dough is fine.
You
so
let me make one?
You can, now, yeah.
Yes. Okay, you just give me a made one already. Like
no, we have to cut it.
Okay, wow. Hey, hey. I have to start from scratch.
Look, my girl. Look.
Yay!
Look, you might think. Anyway, right. Okay. So they make different kinds of different shapes, right? So my grandmother used to make something like a little beak and put it in, drop it in there. Sometimes they would make a round one, depending on how they feel, and sometimes they'd make one like a loaf. All right. Like a loaf and just drop it in, all right? So we would make, go ahead, Mona Lisa, cut.
Yes, okay, thank you. Mona Lisa is cutting.
Mm-hmm. Be careful with your finger, miss.
Yes.
All right.
Be very careful with my finger and... Okay, thank
perfect.
You.
All right.
A little uneven, but they're good for bouillon.
Yes, for the bouillon. You see, because the bouillon is just a soup, and I think I am not 100% sure as to the history of the bouillon, but one thing I know for sure is that bouillon was, growing up, I saw bouillon more like a midweek thing, a weekend thing, a Saturday thing, like when everybody's in the garden or so, or if there's a self-help project going on, because everything just goes into the pot and you could forget it for a while.
Yeah.
Right? So when you forget it, you know, you put everything in, you forget it. When you go back, you probably just go stir the pot because everybody's busy doing something else. And for us, it has become the one pot staple that everybody enjoys. And for the bouillon, I could tell you, depending on the community you're from, the contents of your bouillon would differ. If you're from Choiseul, where you have a lot of carrots and cabbages and stuff, and cabbage, stuff like that, you would find all of that being put into the pot. Now, I grew up in the north. My grandmother was from Moshi, the Moshi area. We didn't have carrots and cabbage and stuff like that. So it was more provisions, spinach and stuff like that. So just like in Italy, you find the dishes in Italy differ depending on what region you're in. The same applies to us here. Although we are a very small island, the same applies. So depending on whatever was grown in your garden, that was what constituted your bouillon. All right?
Mm-hmm. Good. And that doesn't only apply to food. When you look at the island, our accent varies in different dishes.
Yes. So our dumplings are made. For the dumplings, we normally toss them in a little bit of flour so they do not stick together. Mm-hmm. All right, so they remain very loose. So you will set that aside. So that's actually one of the last things that go into the pot because it cooks very quickly. And for us, I always heard when the dumpling floats, that means it's good. Mm-hmm. Whenever it comes to the surface, that means it's good. All right, so we're gonna set that aside here with everything else.
Right.
Okay, so we'll wait for our pot to get to ready. Mm-hmm. And then, so in the meantime, we'll wash and we'll get to the avocado and furin.
So all right. Before we get to that avocado and furin, our favorite, yes? We shall take a well-deserved break. Stay with us.
Want to know what keeps us going? The moments that inspire. The moments that excite and unite. You who have journeyed with us and built our legacy.
Is that your bro? Now we know we be. Tell our best at least.
Beat up.
Let the egg my be.
Want to know what keeps us going? Simple. That good St. Lucian vibe.
We come from the islands and when we drinking is pizza.
One thing's for sure, it's always a celebration with us.
Pizza, I bet it's a pizza.
Cheers to 30 years of vibe.
Welcome back, everyone. We are just about to start our avocado and furin balls.
Yes. Okay, so we have our furin here in our calabash. Mm-hmm. What I have done before, what I did before, our lovely guests here, they're having cherry and
guava
nectar and soursop juice. But what I've done is introduce them to our local snack that kids crave. So it's furin with brown sugar and some coconut milk. So this is something that you would snack on. Sometimes it is just cream, as we used to call it in our day, or just sugar, or just on its own, or it's a killer with coconut. When you have furin and you just bite into the dry coconut, oh my god, this is killer.
Yes,
I'll have you taste it in a bit.
Yes,
so in we're making our furin and avocado balls.
Okay.
So we'd have the furin, just put it in here. Mm-hmm. And one thing I learned from my granny is always to moisten the furin before. So you kind of wet it with just regular water, just to create, because it's very dry, which is, it would absorb a lot of the liquid, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we just add the water. How do you call it? I can't remember the word she used. But that is something you did when you had the furin and you were eating it with a fish sauce or anything.
Mm-hmm.
You had to wet it first. Just, mm-hmm, I can't remember the term that they use, but it's just for me, just to moisten it. Okay.
Oh, you can smell it?
Yes,
yes, it's
amazing.
Smell it.
When the water brings out the smell of the
water.
Yes. And you can see that many people use the same things, but add their own little twist, because mm-hmm, I've never seen anyone add water to it.
Yeah. So we add the water just to make it, because furin on its own, it absorbs a lot and it kind of doubles, right?
Yes.
So, all right, so we're at that point here. So then, mm-hmm, what I would do is just cut in the avocado.
Yes.
All right. So that part is not all that, so we're gonna leave it right there. And we scoop out.
Don't you just love avocado for its health benefits?
In particular, one of the healthiest fats.
I mean, I don't love avocado for the health benefits, but I love it for the taste. I love the mellowness about it.
Yes.
I know a lot of people who don't like avocado, but I think it's one of my favorites.
Yeah,
yes, it is one of the
avocado season is the best season.
Agreed.
And the thing is, with avocados, it is such a versatile fruit,
yep,
that it goes from sweet to savory, because, and a lot of people use it in their smoothies now.
Yes, yes, yes.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And
okay.
Yes, and for us, because sometimes when you have 6 avocados and all of them ripen at the same time,
okay,
it's kind of difficult to use all at the same time. You can scoop it out,
mm-hmm,
and freeze it. Yes.
Yeah.
So you do not have to go to the grocery store to buy the imported ones. You can have it. You can have your local homegrown organic ones, because I am yet to come across an avocado tree that is not organic in St. Lucia. Because they just grow. I've never seen anybody give them any kind of fertilizer or anything. They're just in your backyard and they just grow.
Yeah.
All right, so.
At least now we know that in the event that we have too many avocados on our hands, we can do breakfast,
mm-hmm,
like our tacos.
Oh, yeah.
You know, mm-hmm, or our sandwiches or whatever. We can do it in our smoothies.
Yes.
We can do some farine and avocado balls.
Mm-hmm.
We can use it in lunch, dinner, hair mask, face mask. It's very good for your skin as well.
Yep.
So there's so many things we can do with it. So let's try not to get our avocados go to waste.
Oh, mm-hmm, yeah. Coincidentally, I had this morning in my sandwich,
wow,
with some tuna fish.
Exactly. See?
Oh, yeah.
That's why my skin is glowing right now.
Quick and easy.
All right.
Right.
So you can season it salt and pepper.
Yes.
Depending on what you're doing. If it's, some people put garlic in it, some people put onions and so.
Mm-hmm.
For me, like I said earlier, I like the authenticity. I like the real flavors. Avocado is a very mild flavored fruit, and the fern itself is a very mild flavored thing. So I don't usually put anything in it. Plus, it's normally paired with saltfish or smoked herring, so that is already salty. Yes. So we normally most times just leave it in the pan. Right?
Mm-hmm. Any technique going on there, that work?
No, I'm actually just blending the avocado into the farine. And for you could have, again, the consistency would be up to you, mm-hmm. depending on what you're looking for. Some people like it very hard, some people like it very soft. For me, when I am making it, I like a good balance, because if it is too hard, then that means it's dry. Mm-hmm. So you kind of lose the avocado-y flavor that needs to be in there.
Yes.
Right? So this consistency for me is fine. Mm-hmm. Let me just put this on the side here.
Well, let's do a little quiz time. Do you know what fish is usually known as saltfish?
No.
Mona Lisa, no. Do you remember?
I remember. It's cod. Codfish.
Ah, oh, wow.
It's usually the fish that we refer to as saltfish. So whenever we say saltfish, we're referring to cod.
Okay.
Most of the time, yes.
Yes. You have the codfish?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. So we got it.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. All right.
So for some people, they will want to sprinkle salt at this time, mm-hmm. salt, pepper, whatever it is they want to, but I am not going to put anything into it because my saltfish, which is going to form the base, the bed that our ball is going to lay on, it's already salted and most of the flavor is going to be in there, so you could actually break it in. Okay. All right.
I don't know, I've been itching to just try that pork. I don't know. No. My hands just, you know.
So we're gonna rest this, we're gonna put this on the side, we're going back for our chopping board.
Alright.
And my knife.
A very interesting chopping board. No, it's never saw one so.
Wow, okay.
Thank you.
Have you?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Onion is back on the table.
Yeah.
All right, so we're gonna peel into our onions.
There we go.
See ya. Put your hand aside, yeah.
Disregard it out.
You understand?
I wanted
to come in and say something. But
one thing I learned in culinary school, we keep the base on when we're chopping onions to hold it together.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you take the base off, it kind of, remember, onion is layer, right? So, okay, for our base, we're gonna do a fine dice, right? A fine dice.
I think you need to give us some knife tips.
Maybe tricks. Nice skills.
Come back for some.
Okay, so we're gonna make a fine dice.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Alright, so make a fine dice. I kind of don't do the conventional stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I break all the rules.
You break all the rules? That's my kind of... Oh, that was a secret, sorry.
You learned today that Mona Lisa can't keep secrets.
She can't, not at all. Okay, so we're gonna do... I think I should do a red seasoning pepper to give a little color.
Oh, this one is a red one this time.
A lot of locals tend to use seasoning peppers for color.
Yes.
They like to put greens, blue, I mean blues, sorry.
Yes,
greens, yellows, oranges.
Yeah, because what they say, you taste with your eye first,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Because if the food is not appealing, if it's not appealing to your eye, you just don't want to eat it. And remember, we're in the Caribbean, so it's all about color and splash, right?
Yeah.
Alright, I'm gonna do this. And this tomato.
More like shooting pepper because you have the red, the white, the green.
And then the green over there, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, and some orange, just like your clothes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're trying to mix with our food.
Tomato has entered the chat.
Yes.
Yes. So, I'm gonna do the tomato. Some people like to remove the seeds. I think the seed is one of the most flavorful parts of it.
I agree with you.
I don't know who removes seeds in tomatoes.
Yeah, it's for me that's where the flavor is. Mm-hmm. So I don't. So try to get everything about the same size as the onion. All right.
Yeah.
Unlike the soup where it was just a rough chop, we try to keep the sizes uniform, right?
Okay.
Okay.
All right, and then the tomato is going in the balls, in the farine balls?
It's going to the saltfish.
Ah, and then, all right.
Yes.
Okay. Very nice combination. So while we are chopping, I'm just intrigued by the chopping skills.
Yeah, sorry, I'm sorry. I'm a little mesmerized right now.
You know already, me and knives. And I know knives are a chef's tool.
Yes. Okay, so these chives were pulled out of my garden, my herb garden, this morning. So you see the roots are still on and everything else.
Yes,
it's clean, washed and clean. So I'm gonna cut here.
Whites and greens and
yes.
What else you have in your garden?
Everything.
Everything.
It may not bear in the manner that it should, but there's no guarantee that it will grow, but everything is planted in there, you know.
Do you perchance have strawberries?
I had strawberries some time back. Mm-hmm. But again, you know, our climate is it's the love that it needed, I was not able to give it to it. So they disappeared. Alright? But we do I did have some strawberries in there. Okay. Mm-hmm.
And we found out the last time that strawberries can grow here, yeah?
Yes,
we found out a lot of things we grew here that we weren't aware of. Actually,
excuse me, sorry, sorry.
We look at that as an imported fruit. Mm-hmm. What else we have? Grapes.
Grapes. You know grapes grew here. Wow. But some people grew them.
So, yeah, you know the people that grew them, they can make anything and everything happen. Look at the person who grew apples.
Yes, I was just about to say we had an apple tree in Plateau some time ago,
yeah,
a while back. But this is actually one of the coldest spots. It's yes. Way up there, oh, and it's cool. So they actually grow an apple,
wow,
in here. So
I think that was a great point in history.
Yes, I think so myself.
So revolutionary.
Yes, it made many headlines. Yes. Everyone know apple to be something we import, such as the strawberries, the grapes. So seeing that we could create it here, it's like, oh my gosh, okay, wow, okay. Mm-hmm. We don't have to be buying importing this anymore. We could save a little money,
yes,
grow some outside. But it's not for everyone, because not everyone has a green finger.
Mm-hmm. Green thumb, to be exact.
Mm-hmm. I mean, some people have their whole hand is green. That's how they can grow these things, because I'm not too sure how that happened, because I know Senesha is very hot. But speaking of heat, how your hand didn't miss it?
Yeah.
Good.
Okay.
Then
you
do.
Yeah. It's not too hot for you?
No.
No,
it's
we love the heat.
Beautiful, and the breeze is very nice.
Oh.
You know, I would rather the heat over the cold, so I understand.
Me too.
What about the beaches?
They're beautiful.
Oh,
yeah.
Gorgeous.
Which beach have you been to?
Just the one in the resort that we're staying at. Yes.
Pigeon Point.
So we haven't been to the local beaches.
You need to, you know, go travel around before you leave.
Definitely.
Sulphur Springs.
I'm sorry?
Sulphur Springs, have you ever been to
No, we want to do that, and Pitons, we need to do that stuff.
Definitely.
Well, I recommend going very early in the morning because it gets a little hot.
Oh, okay.
A little very hot.
Very
okay.
Hot.
Okay.
Sulphur Springs.
So we're looking at 6 a.m.
Okay.
Try to go as early as possible, or even later in the afternoon when the sun goes down a little bit. It's
6 p.m.
Yeah.
Okay. That's great to know. Have you been?
Oh, many times. Oh, yes. And it's good
for
the skin.
Yes.
And the smell.
My baths are ready.
Okay.
My baths, yes.
So,
is the saltfish ready?
Yes, so we're ready. Yes, yeah, so the saltfish, this is the saltfish here. So this has been, you know, shredded and boiled.
Mm-hmm.
It's simple. So we put it in here. We pour it in here. And we add all of the good stuff in there.
Mm-hmm.
The good stuff.
All of the good stuff. We just put it in here.
Sound effects.
Shwa. Looks very busy. Very upset.
Right?
Yes.
So this is.
We remind you of the salsa for the taco.
Yeah.
Taco.
I think it has the exact same thing.
Yeah.
All right.
I
so.
And
here, and we just.
Maybe.
We just toss it here.
Mm-hmm.
That looks good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I could just put that in bread and eat that. You know, like, you know, experimental purposes.
I'm not against talking in bread. You see, when you have leftover sausage and not enough bread left or green tea, bread is
okay, this would be the base for our avocado and avocado balls, right? Okay. So what we will do, let's go look at our pot to see cooking. Okay, so everything seemed to be coming together very well, nicely. Alright, so we're going to add our dash in here, because everything is fine. Alright. And we're stirring. Probably need to put a little more water in there, because remember it's a soup. And I will add our spinach as well. We'll add our spinach. Okay. And we'll add some more water in there. And the water, yes. Nice, so then we will go cover again. And then we go. Good. All right, so we added the dashi and the spinach and so to our pot.
Yes.
So we're here.
So we are right. Here. We're ready to make.
Okay. So will you do spice?
Yes. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you gotta be always in that.
Alright, so what I will do, when I'm plating, I will put the spice on the side. Because I need you to taste it with and without.
Okay.
Alright, so you'll be able to help yourself with that.
Wow. Alright, I'm covering up the green and
so then. You have to roll the balls, so you will do some rolling as well. You want to do some as well?
Yes,
sir. I don't know if you want to use help gloves or if you want to do it.
As long as our hands are washed.
Yes.
So, okay, so we could do the hand washing across this way.
Alright.
So we do our hand washing. And we're gonna roll.
But while we wait for all that and while it's getting pretty hot, we need to take a little break. We shall be right back.
Want to know what keeps us going? The moments that inspire. The moments that excite and unite. You who have journeyed with us and built our legacy. Want to know what keeps us going? Simple, that good St. Lucian vibe.
We come from the islands and when we drinking is pizza.
One thing's for sure, it's always a celebration with us. Cheers to 30 years of vibe.
Welcome back to Merger Lakai, where we have some rolling going on and we have some avocado balls on the table already.
Yes, avocado balls being made by our guests just so they could get their hands into our local cooking and to get the textures and to see what it feels like. So they will actually be having whatever it is they're making for lunch or as a snack. So, and they seem to be doing a very good job.
Yeah.
A very, very good job.
How's the process going?
Great.
Fun. Looks fun.
Okay, so we will leave them, just let them roll, so we could go back to our melting pot, so we could add our dumplings and to finish off, right?
Time for the dumplings to be added.
You know what that means?
What does that mean?
We're almost done. It's almost time to taste. It's almost time to eat. Mm-hmm. And honestly, I can't wait. Buyo is a staple. Like, when I say staple, because in buyo, you can put anything and everything. Not all buyo is salted meat. There's saltfish buyo, there's lamb buyo, there's chicken buyo. It's whatever you want to make it. You can add
green tea, you can add plantain, you can add breadfruit if you want, you know, anything you want. People do it their own way. Peas, red beans, lentils, whichever
spinach.
What. Exactly. Mm-hmm. It's up to you to make it how you want. That's why we put ourselves as a buyo because of all our mixed cultures
our
in St. Lucia.
Yes.
Okay, so we're going to add our dumplings in here. All right. So we good. Yes, I know somebody's going to be wondering why am I using such a small thing. But I find just sort of quietness, and so we use these and it gets the edges.
What's your favorite buyo?
I have to say pigtail.
You like pigtail.
I had to think about it. I'm like, I am going to be basic and I'm going to go with pigtail because it is the staple, mm-hmm. and I think it's the best.
Yes.
Honestly. I can eat buyo for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And I think I can speak for all Lucians when I say that.
Definitely. I like my pigtail buyo as well. In my kalalu. Kalalu, which is a spinach buyo.
Yep.
We call that kalalu. Yes, I love that. And Tet is back joining us.
Good job.
Yeah,
very, 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 very.
Yeah, and they do that in record time too.
Record time as well. Yes, record time.
Born for this.
Yes, shows you that two is always better than one.
That's right. So we are almost ready for our buyo. So I'm gonna put these away and get ready to plate the
appetizers.
The appies. Yes.
The appetizers. Also, this is gonna be like the side. You know, on my mind, this was going in the balls together.
I mean, she said it was the bed.
It was yes, the bedding.
You know.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So when you go to sleep, you don't mix with your bed.
You sleep on your bed. That's right.
Forever, yeah.
I mean, last time I checked, I don't think you can mix with metal or wood.
No. You know? Sheets. Want to wash up? Yes.
And we are waiting.
Yeah, so as they're washing out their hands, mm-hmm. getting ready, clean, everybody's preparing for what's about to come next.
Even my belly prepared it. One thing. Are y'all ready? The viewers. I hope you are. Oh boy.
This one is a good one.
This one is a good one. This one is a great one.
Oof.
Ba-dum, ba-dum. Yes. I see Pet come there with another kind of energy. I'm like, whoa. Listen, time boy.
Oh yeah, so we're going to be creating. So again, we have our saltfish with all our some people like to cook it, but I think for something as this, because you have a very earthy flavor with the furin and the avocado, I think the natural raw flavors blend better together. It can be cooked, like sauteed together, but I prefer having it in its raw state. Having the vegetables and so in its raw state, mm-hmm. right? So, I'm gonna have this, yeah.
Those colors just pop on the white.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hence the reason for me always liking white plates.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yes. I find colored plates kind of take away a lot from the food. It gets lost in the color.
I never thought about it like that.
Yes, it does get lost in color. And I like odd numbers.
So like the three is the worst.
Yes. I do not like even numbers with anything I do. Except my children, I have two.
She can't even.
Except my children, I have two. Okay, now, since we're doing the spice, what I want you to taste it without, with and without, I will just put a little blob of it. Mm. Our local baron pepper, which is world renowned.
Bigger baron sauce, yes.
This is world renowned, so we're just gonna.
Sauce.
So we're just going to drag here, alright? So, and if anything,
the garnish is important.
Yeah. we do our stuff here.
That's a different thing. $10 plate and $100 plate.
Yes. Presentation.
Yes.
Everything.
Let me tell you, presentation, presentation, presentation. Mm-hmm. Okay, you could see that it's all real, authentic food. It is not refined, it's not over-refined, it's not overworked, right? So you get the natural flavors of the avocado, the natural flavors of the farine, the cassava farine, and the saltfish, and the natural stuff in there. All right, so we're gonna give you this. Let me just get you.
I cannot wait for y'all to give your honest opinion.
Yeah, honest one. Yeah.
Honest critiques. I want honesty across the board, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Can't wait. Yes.
And just like their union, they are sharing it.
Is there like a right way to eat this or a proper way?
No.
Well, not really. I mean, yeah, like, I was about to say that.
I mean, there's no right or wrong way.
Okay. You just eat.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Bye.
What's this, this though?
Without the sauce.
Just bring it closer to you, yes. If you're without the sauce, and then we're going.
Wow.
Yeah.
That is incredible.
Oh.
Oh my gosh. Okay, mm-hmm. Now with the sauce.
With the sauce, yes.
Wow.
A lot of it nodding, yes.
So what,
yes.
What flavors pop out at you?
That's delicious.
The fish right away and then the avocado base.
I feel like you taste everything at mm-hmm. one point.
Mm-hmm.
All mixed together.
Nice. Wow, that sauce.
Lots. This is what it's about.
It's very spicy.
Nice.
And it's spicy too, right?
The beans are right there.
Oh my god, get them away. It's delicious.
Like, wow. Yeah, but this is what I like, and well, that's I think cooking should be. You need to be able to actually identify the flavors that mm-hmm. you. Every item should be able to be identified on its own, and then when you put it together, you create that masterpiece.
Yes.
Right?
I can taste everything in there.
Good.
With each bite, there's a different
yes,
flavor.
Yes, good. Perfect.
I think that's a 10 out of 10 if I didn't
find this was like so right
now. Yeah, you will. No, I'm saying that I believe they give you a 10 out of 10.
Oh.
Yes.
Yes.
So,
yes. Good.
Good job.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank
delicious.
You.
Oh, yes.
Thank you.
Turn.
Yeah. So your turn will come after.
My turn will come.
Yes. I'm happy that you enjoyed it.
Mm-hmm. And I love it with and without the sauce.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Nice. So you see, because you realize I didn't add any salt to the avocado.
Right.
Because the salt from the base, the salt fish, right. would blend in perfectly.
Yes, it does.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Voila.
Delicious.
Good.
Yay.
All right.
Mm. Okay.
Now. Onto the main course.
Onto the main course. So, okay, our bouillon is what's ready. Yeah, what's ready. So you see, we have our meats, we have our dumplings, we have our dashing and our spinach, and the split peas is almost melted, so you could barely see it. But this is what it is. You could see it is not really overly thick. Yeah. But it's good enough, right? So let me just place it in.
Is this the first local dish you're having since you've been here?
I believe so. Yes. They had
really?
The, besides the
well,
bread.
We had swordfish.
We did have swordfish last night.
Mm.
It was very good. Grilled. What else did we have? We had some jerk chicken with some
okay, jerk is
sauce.
Not local.
No,
yeah,
not
it's
local.
Jamaican, actually. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
But I'm glad that you're enjoying our local cuisine
yes.
and it is appealing to you. Because I know sometimes it's a little bit different, so it might just be a little shake up from what you're used to versus what is served locally.
Definitely. You think y'all gained enough knowledge to teach the folks back home?
Do you think y'all will attempt it?
Yeah.
I hope so.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
And it's easy. They showed you the easiest way. This
yes.
is one of the easiest snacks. And when you see the bouillon,
the bouillon
realize it's not hard. A lot of our local dishes are very, very simple.
Yes.
It's usually two components
mm-hmm.
or a one pot like that. So,
I need to, I probably need to put a bigger portion for you, right? Since you don't eat this.
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
I wish I could.
You're gonna miss out, you're missing out a lot. Okay, so just let me prepare another plate for you.
Okay.
So you can have, yes.
That looks amazing.
It does, and I like the bowl.
Yeah, it's very pretty. Again, white.
It's square.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna make this to pop out more. You can see
I just believe in white plates.
I mean, maybe that's why a lot of restaurants have white plates.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, my home only have white plates, see? White plates is generic in a way. What about you? Your house?
You know, we have our white plates, but then every once in a while you want a pop of color, especially when it comes to holidays and festivities and stuff like that. So we have more colorful plates, but generally a lot of the plates are white for everyday use, so typical hangout and whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah.
True.
Alright. Oh, I thought she was
going
to
stick
to
four.
No.
I actually, on a serious note, I have I don't know if it's a complex, but I just cannot take on. I may be OCD, maybe not, I don't know.
Which is
old? No, but I much prefer even numbers.
You mean odd numbers?
Yes, odd numbers, sorry.
I believe you have a little love for even numbers somewhere.
Well, my sons, I have two. So this is you. All right, Mona Lisa, and I will put, let me get your stuff for you.
Yes,
all.
We are about to do that.
You know, we can wait. We can let the guests try first.
Well, yes, okay, you can go ahead. So we have our bouillon. This is pigtails with dashin dumplings, and again, there wasn't.
That's delicious. Yeah. I get more.
Mm-hmm. I think it's so rewarding to see someone else from a different culture tasting our food and enjoying it.
Yes,
it is refreshing to see.
So we have the dumplings, the dashin, the spinach, the meats. And so it's as you could see, it's very simple, but you get the flavors out. And I say to everybody that cooking is always about time and temperature. Mm-hmm. So you need to know how long, at what temperature, and how long to keep it. It's all about time and temperature. So
it's a science.
It is a science. Cooking actually is a science.
Yeah.
I'm glad you taught us.
Yeah, and you learned so much today. Mm-hmm. So maybe you can go home and try it, or even tell people about it. I mean, the show is still up for y'all to look back on it and follow the instructions all over again. And it will make it fresh in your mind because you were indeed here and you did see the whole process. So I'm hoping that you all actually do try it.
Yes, and you can cut style on the people. We have a phrase, cut style, you know? Make them jealous that you can cook that. Yes. Ooh, I heard my name and I see a bowl. Yes. Make that square and symmetrical for the OCD people.
So,
yes.
The other thing that is very, very, very local, and I think every good meal, especially a local meal, needs to end or have a pita in between right there.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yes.
So, without further ado, we're going to get you your pita.
I mean, when you have a name like that, you can't go wrong.
Above the rest, because above the rest, yes.
I think Piton was the first thing we had when we got to St. Lucia.
Oh yeah?
Yes, very first thing.
Just put that in your hand. You
yes, exactly. It was the best welcome.
Yeah. I believe that's our way of saying welcome to St. Lucia.
Yes. So if you don't climb it, you will drink it.
Yep.
You gotta showcase it somehow.
I mean, I'm not going to be the one to climb.
Oh, girl!
I will drink one for you.
True. I would most probably climb than drink it.
They have a bear is a piton, they say.
Our bed is a pizza, they say.
Mm? Yeah. A nice cold one.
Yeah. Okay. So here's the other one.
The taste is still amazing.
Okay.
Thank you.
So, just taste, please. Yes. Yeah. Thank you.
Going all in on that one, eh? Because yours is the temperature.
Wow, that's delicious.
Awesome. Now you've had the full submission experience, local food, and a local beer.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You are so welcome.
Good. I'm happy that you enjoyed everything. It was a pleasure having you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I'm happy
to
enjoy it. Welcome. Welcome. Don't let it be the dam, the dam, da da the dam, the
dam, the dam, da da the dam. Want to know what keeps us going? The moments that inspire, the moments that excite and unite. You who have journeyed with us and built our legacy.
It's a your blood. Now we know we be. Tell a beer said listen. Beat up. Let the egg my beat.
Want to know what keeps us going? Simple. That good St. Lucian vibe.
We come from the islands and when we drinking is beat up.
One thing's for sure. It's always a celebration with us.
Beat up. I bet it's a beat up.
Cheers to 30 years of vibe. Go go beat up. Beat it, beat it, beat it, beat up.
If I'm not mistaken, I think it's our turn to taste.
Yes, it is.
It's our turn.
It is
your turn to taste. Sorry.
Oh, no, don't apologize.
It's all right. You know that gets come
first. And like magic, we have Buyo for days. One in a bowl, one in a calabash.
Are you ready to sit?
Oh, we are ready. You can't even sit the word.
No, I started a little bit. You know, I'm just so... The food right in front of me. I don't know what's taking so long now. Ready?
Ready.
That is some authentic Buyo right there. I think you have literally created my exact favorite Buyo. And I really appreciate it. It's amazing. And you were so right. You don't need a lot to change the flavors. You can really taste in the sauce itself. You don't even have to have the pigtail. You're tasting it already.
Yeah.
It's really good.
It's like all of the pigtail flavor diffuse right into the soup. It is amazing. There is a burst of flavor. Let's see the consistency of the ground provision. It's already melting on my spoon.
I literally forgot to put dash in it.
Because
yeah, and listen, to me the dumpling was so big. But wow.
You forgot the dash in?
Yeah, but wow. It is so soft and smooth and buttery and
melts
just melting your mouth.
Yes.
I forgot there was hard food in this. It's really soft.
I'm going for the dumpling right now.
Oh, okay, I got a dumpling.
Oh, yeah. How dumpling is supposed to be. How is dumpling supposed to be? It also gives me a melt in the mouth kind of feel. Not like the ones where you know you eat on the side of the fish. No, not that kind. It is the Buyo kind for sure.
It's soft, it's mellow. It just adds another element to the Buyo. Wow. Those dumplings are great. It's not hard. It's just perfect. I don't even know how to explain it. I'm so sorry, guys. But it's, you know, the amazement fireworks in my head. I can't even explain.
Man trembling, eh? Pigtail time. Now people, I can't understand how there's people who don't eat pig. Because you see right now, I find it so blasphemous. This is like, amazing. The salt from that pig, it's not too much, it's not too little, it's just well.
It's just good.
It's just there.
I understand exactly what you're saying about a specific temperature for a specific time. The pigtail is so soft, you can literally cut it with a spoon. And sometimes you don't get that experience. Sometimes you have to really pick it up and, you know, mm-hmm. eat it. And I'm not against those types of buyos. But this one, mm-hmm. it's very appropriate for where we are. Mm. You know, I don't have to, you know.
You put your hand in.
No, this is a beautiful setting. So, you know, we need to use all our, you know, table manners.
Yes.
And it's, yes. it really makes it all very easy because everything is nice and soft and just
palatable,
yeah. delicious.
Yes. And they say when the food is in a calabash, it tastes better.
It tastes better, yes.
Mm-hmm. What's the science behind that one?
I have no idea.
Mm-hmm. I think that it's local, and local tastes better.
It's just like when you eat food with your hand, for some reason it tastes better.
Yeah,
it does taste better. So,
well, let me tell you, calabash, hand, spoon, everything is to the sea. Very
happy. I'm happy that everybody enjoyed
everything. Find them on Facebook, guys. Facebook, Instagram, all that jazz. You will not regret.
Anyways, guys, we're gonna finish our food because I cannot fathom waiting any longer to just dive in. Yeah. And we will see you next time. Thank you so much for joining us. How much is it?
Aïe aïe, manger à colin, banane, qui donne à manger. Aïe aïe.